Good morning, let's get started. So 7 days ago, we had seen how to work with user datagram protocol. And we have seen in Java that we had java.net, java.net package, and inside to it we have datagram socket and datagram packet as classes. And these classes helped me to program in client-server paradigm. So from the client, I was requesting some information to the server, and the server is processing my information and is replying to me. As analogy, how? By sending letters, exactly like in Andrew Tannenbaum book, from the Indian philosopher to the Chinese philosopher, I'm sending a letter, and then I'm waiting for a reply, and then I'm receiving the letter as a response. And this is the user datagram protocol. Today, I'm going to explain the TCP, transmission control protocol, this part from here, which means in Java directly to use also package java.net, but from it, we are going to use server socket class and socket class. And this type of programming, this approach, allows me as a programmer, as a software developer, to have the analogy with the phone. So I'm calling a friend. Once he is answering to me, then the communication is established. And this is a connection-oriented protocol, right? So we have a set of rules, which after we are establishing the connection, I can send as a client to the server a request, a question or whatever, but is a request, and the server is processing that request and is replying to me with the answer, so with response. So I have request response in connection-oriented manner. As analogy, again, is like I'm calling a friend, the friend is answering to me, the connection is established, and therefore, once the connection is established in TCP, you are going to see we have TCP handshake, 2+1 packets exchanged, and I'm going to show you, together with a state machine on both sides, client and server, then I have this sensation because of the high rate of transfer because of digital electronics, right? I have this sensation of continuous flow, continuous stream between the client and the server. And the client to the server in Java is going to have output and input, right? And the server to the client back is going to have, again, output and input. And therefore, I'm going to have a mirroring, or whatever you want to call it, intersection. So what is for me as a client, right? You are going to see immediately in the source code. Let me explain to you directly. So I'm jumping to this slide. Right. So I have the server. In the left side, I have the client. Once I'm using the server socket class from java.net, the constructor with parameter, let's assume I'm going to use, for instance, parameter 8777. So port with number 8777, right? So in that time, the constructor is going to call the system primitives, socket, bind, and listen. Let me show you directly here. So let me see if I have it. No, I have only for datagram. I'm switching immediately to the source code, and I'm going to show you here, right? So once I have my server socket, right, equals new server socket, whatever port, here is 4801, right? Those three primitives already are done, right? Then I'm entering in blocking accept. This blocking accept is actually helping me to why I'm saying blocking. The method is non-static, and as you can see, is an object from this class, server socket. Is blocking because I'm not going to exit from it, me as a server, unless a client is connecting to me. So unless I have TCP handshake. And therefore, immediately after TCP handshake, I have what? I have in equals, you see my mouse in here, new buffer reader, new input stream reader, and IS, which IS is client socket get input stream. Who is client socket? Is an object which is filled by JVM, Java Virtual Machine, so Java process when it's running in the operating system, once the TCP handshake is done with the server socket. And therefore, I'm into established connection. And right now, I'm doing my best to show you better what is with this in and out. So for me, as a server in this scenario, right, when I'm getting here, get input stream actually is happening the following. Allow me to annotate, right? I'm doing my best to draw as simple as possible. So I'm putting here with blue and I'm saying, okay, I have input stream. I'm trying to put in here. So I have input stream this, right? So this is my input stream. Give me a few moments. camel. Okay. So this is the input stream. I will explain immediately. Give me a few moments more. So this is the here, the get input stream, right? So this I'm trying to do. This is the input stream. And what I'm going to do with the input stream, I'm going to wait connections from the client. So allow me please to draw. I'm going to wait to come bytes, vice versa, to come bytes from the client. This is me, right? Then moving forward, and I'm going to put with black right now, I'm going to prepare a stream where I'm replying back. Look at this OS client, right? So this one from here, I'm going to select to underline with black, right? So I'm going to prepare a stream from the server side to reply back to the client, right? So look, let me draw the arrow. So I'm moving bytes from the server back to the client. And for this, I'm going to draw a pipe, a stream with black in this case, like this and like this. And what I'm saying is in the mirror. Let me show you. So let me finish this draw and you will understand in a bit, right? So you see, I have, yeah, I'm not electronic artist and I do not have a tablet yet. I mean, I have it, but I have to configure and so on and to draw better, right? And as you can see in here, why is in the mirror this? Because in the client side right now, please take a closer look. So you see on the client side, I have right now with what I have as an input stream in here, get input stream, and I put it with blue, right? So what is the input stream for the client in here is going to be in the mirror with the output from the server. So what I have it, let me show you. What I have it on the server side, and I put it with red like this, right? Until I'm getting in this while. So I'm preparing here in this area, I'm preparing whatever is necessary, including the wrapping of the streams, the wrapping of the streams. This is in the server side. In the client side, as you can see in here, in the mirror, I have what? Client socket get output stream. This is yet another program in this side and is running on in another Java virtual machine and eventually in another node in the network, another computer, another server. So it's the client, right? So in here, I'm doing what? I'm doing with blue, client socket get input stream. Who is client socket? Look in here. Client socket is an object from socket class. Where I'm passing as a parameter, of course, the IP address where I'm going to obtain the connection to discuss with. So I'm the Indian philosopher, I want to discuss with the Chinese philosopher, therefore I have to provide the IP and the port where I'm connecting, right? In this case is 4801, but could be another port and I'm going to show you in a bit. So right now, coming back, I'm going to put again what I had here with blue, I'm going to put with blue, let me put in here like this. So this was, yes, the blue side. I did not, I don't want to charge the drawing to have, you know, the wrapping, because wrapping this pipe, wrapping this stream yet within, I mean, with another stream is going to complicate the drawing. But you understood my point, I'm pretty sure. If not, please ask via chat or via mic. So let me finish this. So this is what I had with blue on this side, right? And now I'm commuting on black. And as you can see here, I have client get output stream. And right now I'm going to have with black. Allow me please to do this. And then I'm saving the drawing, right? So like this. Yeah, and sorry again, I'm not an electronic artist yet. So I have to learn from my wife. Okay, so I have something like this, right? And as you can see in here, I'm going to draw this pipe, this stream actually, because it's a stream. Okay. Okay. And here, of course, I can choose another color yet green and saying, look, this is the client side. So as you can see, in few line of codes, two line with this emphasis is in green in here and the two line in red in the server side, actually, I create exactly what you see in here, and I'm putting with a neutral color, like something like magenta or whatever, right? So I have created the output of the client side, put it in the correspondence with the input of the server side, and vice versa, the output of the server side, put it in correspondence with the input of the client side. And that's why I have these pipes. So once this is done, the accept here is going to be escaped the server from this blocking point only if and only if the client is connecting to me. So I have TCP handshake. Then I'm moving forward. I'm establishing these streams of communications. And once these streams of communications are established, look what I have in here. So the client is saying in Romanian language, and I'm putting with, let's say, another color, so with green, is saying, aș vrea să mă conectez. I would like to connect in English, right? So as long as I have aș vrea să mă conectez, these bytes from here, this part from here, serialized or not, doesn't matter. Depends if I apply serialization or not. So I would have small squares like bytes. Allow me please to do this. So these bytes from here are going to travel in the network because, as you can see, I have what? I have out C. Who is what out C? Is print writer wrapping over the get output stream with black from the client side. So these bytes from here are going to travel in the network in the stream-oriented method, the stream-oriented manner, right? So I'm putting them in here with green, right? And I'm drawing an arrow to understand better. So these are flying from here to here, right? So I have something like this. Then these bytes are coming to me as a server, and my server is doing with another color, with red, for instance, is doing what? Is saying input line, read line. So I'm going to read line by line what I'm receiving with green from the client side. And then I'm going to say, okay, I'm replying with okay. Okay is having only three or four bytes. What I'm saying, three or four bytes. You see in here, out.print line is a non-static method. Because of this LN line depends. If I'm on macOS server, macOS is having the enter with just carriage return. So it's 0A in hex or 10 in decimal, right? If I'm on a Linux server is putting the line with line feed, which is 10 in decimal, which is 0A in hex. If I'm on a Windows server, this print line is putting carriage return line feed. So 13 decimal, one byte, another byte, yet 10 value decimal, so 0D, 0A in hex. So as you can see, at max from this OK, I have two bytes because of OK, and then the enter because of right line. So therefore, let's assume are four bytes if I'm in Windows, or in Linux or macOS, three bytes, so less. I'm going to send in the network the reply. So three bytes are going to travel through this stream, right? And is going to enter in the stream from the client, and the client is going to receive and to accept and to understand what the server is saying on the black arrow. So he's saying, look in here what you have incoming. So in my in from here, which was with blue, right? Look, in C equals with client socket get input stream is going to receive these three bytes. And then, of course, I can close the connection. I'm going to save this picture. Are any questions still here? Can I move forward? Let's discuss now, right now, for the following. So I have saved this. Anyway, it's remaining in the stored video. Let's move, let me clear the whiteboard that I had in here. So let's move forward and understand better right now. So what I had on the server side, I had via server socket constructor, this operating system primitives done. I had by calling non-static method accept a blocking method, this operating system primitive accept on the server side. And the read and receive how has been done. So as you remember from this slide, it's obvious that when I obtain the pipe for in and the stream, or let's not call it pipe, stream for in and stream for out, I'm in the case where I can receive the request and read line by line if it's text protocol, or byte by byte if it's binary protocol, and then send it back. You are going to say how text, how binary. So for instance, HTTP 1.0, Hypertext Transfer Protocol 1.0 and 1.1, most of the internet today is a text protocol. Next level internet protocol, HTTP 2.0 or 3.0 are binary protocols, right? And they are pushed by Google, but for the moment they have some momentum, but the market share is less than 10%. So anyway, I have request, I have response, and then close. How is done, and you should put this question as a student, how is done the flow orientation? How is done this acceptance of the connection-oriented protocol? As long, and I'm going to show you again, I have encapsulation. In my encapsulation, this protocol, UDP and TCP, are actually packets. So they are storing in their header the source port and destination port. In our analogy with the Indian philosophy and Chinese philosophy in client-server paradigm, is storing the apartment of the source and the apartment of the destination, including in the TCP. And then as a header of IP, right, as encapsulation, as you can see in here, instead of UDP header, I would have TCP header. I have IP header, which yet is another packet besides my payload, green one, the data, where I have the IP source and IP destination, most likely in version 4. So the street, the number of the street, the block, and so on, until the apartment as analogy, I have it in here in the source and the destination. How in the world I can simulate somehow as a connection oriented, as long as I have also packets, because this then is encapsulated in the frame header where I have my MAC address of source and MAC address of the destination. So the physical address of the network board on the source of the source and of the destination. So therefore MAC address or MAC, right? So how in the world I can, with this encapsulation or not, with this multiplexing or not, right? Because like in a block, I have several apartments which I can associate with the processes. And once they are receiving the packet from the network, they are going to be dispatched by the operating system, the letter, the packet directly to that apartment. So besides this encapsulation and multiplexing, right? How in the world I can have, look in here, in the IP address, IP header, I have source IP address with blue and with origin destination IP address. And if I'm talking about version 4, of course, I have 4 bytes, 32 bits, right? And I have checksum, and very important, I have not so many other things, right? So IP header is common, right, for both UDP, letter-oriented SMS, or TCP, phone call oriented, like analogy, right? So how in the world I can have this? The answer is having two components. One is the state machine I'm going to show you on both sides, client and server, clients and servers. So I have my state machine, and this is maintained by the operating system in conjunction, in discussion with the drivers of the network board. This is one thing. And the second thing, the complexity of the TCP header. Look, please pay attention at this slide number 13. Both UDP, User Datagram Protocol header, and TCP, Transmission Control Protocol header, they have only two major things, source port and destination port. 16 bits, 2 bytes, therefore the value I can encapsulate into it is from 0 to 65,535 positive unsigned int on 2 bytes. Okay, this is the only thing I can do. Look in here, blue and orange. Here I had red and white are the same bits that are stored in the source and destination port. This is for sure. But yes, I have checksum. I have checksum and the length in UDP header. I have checksum in the TCP header. But look how it's done in conjunction with this state machine. The TCP header is far more complex. I have a sequence number of 4 bytes, 32 bits. I have an acknowledged number of 32 bits, and I'm going to show you with Wireshark. And you are going to understand immediately what? The handshake. And after you understand the handshake, then should be clear for each one of you how TCP, with maximum speed of digital electronics, is simulating for me as a software developer and even as a machine, a continuous flow of communication. So besides this sequence and acknowledgement numbers, I have, of course, what is called window size, and then I have some options, and very important, I have this kind of TCP packet. What kind of packet is? Is urgent, is acknowledgement, is push, is reset, is synchronized or is finished, right? So keep in mind this. I'm going to show you them in Wireshark, and you'll understand in a bit. Why? Because, for instance, the handshake, so actually the exchange of the packets that I'm not handling in the source code, but I know it's happening because I'm having a traffic analysis tool, right? So the handshake is taking place with minimum exchange of the packets, right? So the client, when it's opening in the source code terms, and I'm going to show you, when the client, let me show you, right? In here, I did to keep very simple. When the client is saying here, client socket, I'm going to show you via the debugger, new socket, and then it's creating the streams, then please understand, actually, in these steps in here, right, I put it also some comments, is done already the handshake. So actually what is happening in behind? So in the source code, doesn't matter you are in Kotlin, in Python, or in C#, you are not saying, look, send synchronized packet, please. No, you are not going to say something like this, never, ever. But once you have created the socket object on the client side, then a SYN packet, a synchronized packet, is flying in the network, and we are going to see it immediately in the Wireshark. Bam! And once I have it in the server side in here, automatically, I'm getting out from accept blocking source code in Java, in terms of Java. So look, in the server side, automatically the JVM is going to escape me from this blocking statement. Whoops, here to obtain the streams for input and streams for output. So it's getting out with me with the following in behind, transparent for me as a software developer. So I cannot see it. I can see it only like this in the Wireshark, in the network traffic analysis, the packets. And I'm going to show you in a bit. So it's doing what? It's replying with, as you can see, the server is replying with, as you can see here, unfortunately, it's vice versa. I can try to put in the mirror if I can, right? Reorder objects, not to, I'm not going to do it live in here, not to turn like this, but to put in the mirror, right? So let me do my best if I'm doing like this. Ah, no, okay. I'm living like this for the moment. So I have to do a mirroring of this, right? A flipping. So coming back, the server is replying with a packet which is in the same time synchronized and acknowledgement. So therefore, in my traffic analysis, I'm going to see both of these bits, SYN and ACK set. Then I have 010010 in terms of bits, right? So it's in the same time a packet which is SYN and acknowledgement. And once I have it SYN and acknowledgement, then my client automatically is replying with acknowledgement. You are going to say, why they did not have 4 exchange of packages? Why they did not have 2? It's an entire theory. Please read Andrew Tannenbaum. It's still actual in our days. So to understand, you can have N+1 packet exchange. I'm not going to do more than this in terms of networking lecture. Networking lecture is totally separate. But please pay attention in here. I have sequence and acknowledgement number, and I'm going to show you directly live. So I have these 32 bits. And let's assume my sequence is generated on the client side with a number like 999, right? So when it's replying the server back, it's going to put in its own acknowledgement number. So it's in its own field of replying in here, 32 bits, what? 999 plus 1, which means 1000. So this, let me annotate, and then I'm going to save. Right, so this is going to be here and incremented, right? This is one thing. The second thing, my own server side is going to generate its own sequence, exactly like I had in the client side. The server side is doing this. Let me put other color also. So on the server side, I'm putting black as well. So look, right? So the server side is generating this. And once the server side is generating this, look how is exchange. So from now on, the client knows to take this sequence number generated by the server, right? And to increment by 1 in acknowledgement. So 4,999 plus 1 is 5,000. This is fine. And this 1,000 that you have it in here is simply replied. So not incremented, not anything. So from now on, all the messages, and you are going to say is to see it live. Live, I'm going to demonstrate to you, including this state machine. So In this moment, as you can see in here, from now on, in the traffic analysis, all the packets are moving in the network with the payload, with something like, what time is it? Hello, I'm client. Server, be kind and tell me what time is it, right? We have time servers. We have in Microsoft, we have in NTP, we have in Google. So we have all around the world time servers to tell me the time, right? So I, whatever I'm asking, I'm putting as a data, as a payload. But nevertheless, I have the sequence and acknowledgement number. And these are always in sync together with this state machine, I'm going to explain in a bit, and mandatory together with this value when I'm pushing. You see, when I'm pushing in here, my sequence is skipped to 1000, and then 1001, and then 1000, and so on. So I'm keeping these values in order to help client and server to put what? Because this is the main challenge. When I'm receiving the packets from the network, and with this I'm finishing, I'm jumping into demonstration. So when I'm receiving the packets from the packet, instead of UDP in here, please accept this TCP. When I'm receiving the packet from the network, everybody agrees that the packet could travel, one of them, through a larger path, I mean a longer path, going through three switches or hubs in the internet, and the second one only one router. And therefore, the second one is coming to the server or to the client faster than the first one. But with this sequence and acknowledgement number and window size and this state machine, so these two things, and this type of push message acknowledgement and the state machine, me on both client and server side, right, I'm able as a software to sequence, to put in sequence the packets that are received from the network on both sides, and to create that sensation of continuous flow of connection-oriented protocol. Enough talking about the theory. I'm going to right now clear the whiteboard, and let me go right now and to explain to you directly. So I have prepared Eclipse in here. This is the project. And on the on this Eclipse side, I'm going to be the server. Give me okay, give me one moment. And then I'm going to start the Linux as a TCP client. So I have on macOS a TCP server, and you are going to see in a bit. And I have on Linux a TCP client. And between these two, as I have stated before, is mandatory to have the debug on eventually both sides. But me as a programmer, as a software developer, I want to not learn by heart. I want to understand better, and therefore I need a traffic analysis tool. And in production, because I do not have user interface, is mandatory to have what? Is mandatory to have TCP dump. Is very good, right? On the non-production phase, because usually, look, I have user interface, would be nice if I would have something like Wireshark, which is very good, and of course can import and export packets to TCP dump in Linux or whatever other distro of operating system Linux. Good. This being said, look, this is the server. And what I'm going to do in the server side, exactly like I put on the on the slides, PowerPoint slides. So I have a server socket. Look, this server socket is a class which is in JavaNet for sure. Right, this is the package. So I have my server socket, and once I'm giving here as a parameter, this port is going to be socket bind and listen, right? So I'm going to be in socket bind and listen operating system primitive call. So let me put here a breakpoint on line 20. Already I have it. So double click and I have a blue bullet in here. This is the breakpoint because I want to debug this. Okay, once I have it, this I'm moving forward and I have a while true. Usually the server, doesn't matter use UDP or TCP, you have seen that should have an infinite loop, right? Because I'm waiting always clients. And I'm putting here a breakpoint, in my case, statement line 29, to have the accept blocking non-static method from the server socket, which is throwing out, I mean, is returning a client socket, which is an object from socket class. So I'm working on the server side with this server socket and socket classes, I mean, objects from these classes. And on the client side is enough to work only with socket. And you are going to see in a bit. And then once I have it this, you see, I have get input stream, get output stream. And here, of course, I have something like server, the server, look in English, let me put like this, the server, okay. The the server is listening import. In port 4801, right? And here I say the client with the remote, so arrived the client with the remote address, and I'm getting, as you can see in here, I'm getting actually the real address. Either I'm going to do a little bit smaller the text to see, either I'm saying something like this, right, to see better. So I'm getting at address to string to see exactly what client connects to me. And therefore I have here yet another breakpoint. Let's move forward. I'm getting the output stream and input stream. First is the input stream and then output, actually it does not matter. So from each client that connected to me, I'm getting these streams. And once I'm getting these streams, I have what? I have a while in the biggest while in the infinite loop. So this is called nested loop statements, right? So for each client, I'm reading line by line. And whatever is the client requesting from me and displaying on the screen on my side, therefore, I'm replying back from the server side with the okay, flush. And here I'm waiting just if the client is saying to me goodbye, I'm just going only then I'm going to break to get out from this while and treat another client. This is one option to is my protocol, is my set of rule, is a text protocol, as you can see in here, just for fun. So this goodbye, if I receive it, I'm getting to treat to handle the next client and the next client. If I do not receive, I have several options. Either the client is closing the connection to me. So when the client is going to say its socket dot close, a TCP finish packet I'm going to capture in Wireshark. And therefore I'm getting out of this while, and you will see in a bit because I have this breakpoint in here, and coming back to the next client. Here, the problem is the following, which the problem has been already addressed in the seminar, in the lab, when we did the HTTP web server with multi-threading. If a client is connecting to me and I'm going to discuss with him or with it 20 seconds, then the second client has to wait 20 seconds. The third client, 40 seconds. The fourth client, 60 seconds, and so on and so forth. So the problem right now is if I don't want to have TCP timeout, I must introduce the resolving of the clients either through multi-tenancy processes, so multiple Java processes to treat, to handle each client, either through multi-threading. So I'm going to launch one thread to handle, to address each client that is connecting to me, which is not the case in here, and you are going to see in a bit. Good. This being said, let me first run this before starting the debug session. Let me run this. For this also, I'm going to show you on here. Let me show you. I'm going to show you the command line clear. All right. So to see the state machine, this is important. And in this state machine, allow me please to show you, in this moment, I have netstat-na pipe grep on the Linux or macOS machine, I'm in the macOS machine, and 4801 port is not listened in this moment. This is for sure. In the Windows, instead of grep, you may use find string, find str. Then moving forward, what address I have in the Windows, you are going to have ipconfig here. In macOS and Linux, I have ifconfig. And I know that I'm connecting over Wi-Fi. So instead of seeing all the addresses, I would say, yes, I want to grep to see the addresses because I'm in my house. I know exactly. I have a class C of IP version 4 addresses. So my address, as you can see in here of the macOS, is 192.168.1.212, right? So this is my macOS address. Now let me start in this moment in the virtual box the Linux machine, where in the Linux machine is Ubuntu 16, as you can see in here. I'm going to be prepared to show you one thing. So in the settings, please pay attention on the networking, right? So on the network in here over Wi-Fi, because my laptop is connected Wi-Fi, I don't want network address translation, NAT. I want bridge adapter. So in this moment, after this moment, when I'm going to play this Linux in this moment, right? The Linux Ubuntu 16 is going to request from my Wi-Fi router an IP version 4 and version 6 eventually address on that Wi-Fi, as long as it's connected, and is going to receive like is yet another node in the network. So let me show you. So yes, I'm going to have another IP address on the Linux. And between macOS here and Ubuntu Linux here, I'm going to create socket of communications on these IP addresses. Allow me please to show you. Start. This is the password from student. Right. So this is starting in this moment. And let's do it. The communication with capturing the TCP IP traffic, right? So look, I can start Wireshark even right now. What I have to do in the Linux is to enable network. This is one thing. Here in the terminal of Linux, terminal, I'm going to show you what IP address I have. And I'm going to open two terminals. One from here is going to be the client. So change profile to start three. And I think everyone is seeing Power Working Directory here, home stool. Here, I'm going to launch the client. In yet another terminal, right, new terminal, I'm going to launch and yet another profile, change profile to start and two. I'm going to show you the IP address. So ifconfig, right? So I have a lot of addresses, but this is my Linux address, right? So same like in macOS, I have ifconfig grep with 192 dot because I know my class of IPs, right? So I am on the Linux this IP address, and on the macOS, I am this address. Therefore, if I'm pinging each other, I have to see it. So look here, ping 192.168. .1.176, look, is answering to my ping. Vice versa, from the Linux. When I'm going to macOS, ping 192.168.1.212, if I remember correct, right? So here I am immediately to show you. So here I am 212, as you can see, right? Clear by now. So in this moment, is going to reply to me. This means I do not have firewall launch in the Linux. I do not have firewall launch in the macOS. So these two machines are completely seeing each other. In terms of netstat, in terms of my state machine, the one that I have shown you, right? Minus NA grep on 4801, as you can see in here, I have no occupied port. You may see, look, but the server is occupying this port. Yes, the server is occupying this port, but please pay attention. And now you are going to understand in a bit. Please pay attention. If I'm going and I'm going here in Java SE, right? In the lecture, we are in the lecture. I know we are in week 12, but I'm still in the semantic of the 10th week with this TCP. So in this lecture, if I'm going in, let me open this command compile txt, which you get used already. Each lecture is having its own command line, right? And I'm going to focus immediately on the TCP side. I'm going to run this TCP simple 04. What is having this TCP simple 04? Is having in EU ASA, right, net, I'm going to have in TCP packet, my TCP client class, right? So not the server, but the client. So as you can see here in this class, I'm going to open with GNU editor. What I'm doing, I'm receiving as a parameter the IP address and the port where I'm connecting. I'm creating a socket. I'm on the client side here. So I'm not using server socket and socket anymore. I'm just using only socket class. I'm getting the output stream and the input stream. And immediately after I did this, I would say to the server, I would like to connect. Then what date is it? And I'm going to receive with read line only okay, always okay, because this is what I did on the server side. what time is it? Would be kind of server to reply to me with the time. I did not do this. And then I'm sleeping on purpose 20 seconds, 20,000 milliseconds. Therefore, if I'm going to launch yet another process with this, that another process has to wait another 20 seconds. And then me as a client, I'm saying out.close because of this statement from line 62, then a finished packet is going to travel in the network and my socket is going to be closed. Before jumping into the debug session, let me show you the behavior on two clients, right? So behavior on two clients right now. So I'm going here and try to compile. So on the both of them, I'm exporting the environment variables, right? So on the both of terminals, this is one thing, right? Still I have IFE config, this is for sure. And still I'm clearing this, right? And Power Working Directory is the lecture number 10 yet. So I'm going yet in another terminal in the black one, right? The one that I had open. And in this black terminal here, I'm going also to set the same environment variable because I want to compile. So here, to see differently, I'm in this lecture number 10. Now, I'm moving in GNU editor and I'm going to not run UDP client server. We have discussed this. Not multicast, you have to investigate yourself. And I'm going to sockets and TCP. And the socket in TCP, I'm going to go to try to run only the client, and the client I'm not going to debug in command line. That was fun. So I'm just trying to run as a simple command line. So what I'm going to do in here, I would say CD on both of them. Actually, I know. I want to compile this. So please pay attention. In this moment, I do not have on the client side any class, right? So all I want to do is to compile the client. It's enough to go in only one window, cd tcp client 04. Right, so cd tcp simple client 04. And in here, I want to compile. Once I'm compiling this, once I'm going to press enter, here I'm going to have TCP client.class, right? The result of the output. So it's enough to do it in only one window because I'm doing the compilation. As you can see right now, here I have the class. And now I'm planning to run this class. And in order to run also on the command line to see the behavior, you may encounter in here no issue. Let me show you. So I'm running the client. And the client that I'm running, okay, I'm going to write down myself the command line. So the client is going to be something like Java minus class path, the current folder. And from the current folder, I want eu.asa, the package, .net.tcp. And in here, I'm going to call TCP client.class, but I'm not putting .class anymore, you know very well. In continuing with the argument zero, first argument and second argument. So I want to connect to macOS, which is having IP 192.168.1.212. And then the port where I'm connecting, 4801. Right, so I'm planning to do this. So I'm planning to copy this command line and let me show you first the behavior here. Right, so copy, and I'm getting to be I'm planning to be ready also in that another terminal in the white one. Right, so in the white one in here, so cd tcp simple 04. And here I'm planning to be ready as well. Now, please pay attention. Eventually, if you want, I can on macOS start the Wireshark. And in order to not capture all the traffic from my laptop, because I might get afraid what is happening, I'm saying, look on the Wi-Fi, right? On the Wi-Fi interface, I want to capture all the packets of the TCP, which are dealing with port 4801. Enter. And now I'm listening in Wireshark, whatever packets are coming from the network to my macOS, right? So in here, as you can see, netstat again, net stat minus NA grep 4801 is nothing. When I'm running the server in this moment, because it's doing the constructor and I'm going to show you in a bit, I have my server running. And of course, let me show you this. This I'm putting like this to get immediately to what I need, right? So in here, if I'm giving again, so I'm listening as a state machine, as a PowerPoint slide theory. And I have this machine isn't listening. What is getting out from me, me as a server from listening, I'm going to show you in a bit. But right now, let me show you the behavior on the Linux side. On the Linux side, this client, if I'm connecting right now, is doing the exchange. I'm going to capture the exchange on the Wireshark, but is waiting 20 seconds. Therefore, the second client coming have to wait 20 seconds, as you can see in here, until this client with white is going to finish the communication, right? Otherwise, I'm not going forward. I have my client asking what time is it, right? Now, only now, the second client connected up after the first client finished, so after 20 seconds. So as you can see in here, in terms of state machine, right? So I have what? I have right now where the second client is communicating with me. If I would be very fast for a second, I can see two established connection before. I mean, if I have multiple clients and I have multi-threading, I have listening, and in the state machine, I have established for each client the state machine, and I'm going to explain right now to you in a bit. Now, in terms of TCP handshake, I'm going to explain on the Wireshark, but what you can see in here, you have seen two sessions, right? So this is first SYN ACK, ACK, the handshake, between 192, 168, 176, as you can see here, is a TCP packet from Linux to my macOS, which is in suffix 212, right? Look from the port where it's coming, 54896, to my port 4801, right? I did the exchange, and once I did the exchange, I have communicate from packet, look, left click, right click, follow TCP stream. From what packet I have communicated? I have received from the client I would like to connect, I reply with okay. I have received from the client what date is it, I replied me as a server with okay, and so on and so forth. From what to what packet I have discussed? 1, 2, 3, 8, 9, 10, 12, and then from 15, I have a jump after 20 seconds, to the client packet, finish, because the client, Linux, close the connection to me. This was this jump from 15 to 12. Let me show you, emphasize to highlight the second client. When is coming the second client to me? Here at packet 16. And if I'm going to follow TCP stream, again, I have the same flow of communication. I would like to connect, okay, blah, blah, blah. But look, I have 16, 17, 18, 19, 20 packet, 27, 28. And then I have a, as you can see in here, I have a jump from 21 to 25 because 22, 23, 24 were packets for closing the connection of the first client, right? So as you can see, this was the second client from the Linux. Why? Look at the source port of the Linux port, TCP port came to me. 54898 in suffix, and the first one was 896, so decreasing with two or increasing with two, depends where. So the first client comes from this port, the second client plus two comes from the next port, 5489. Now let me show you, and with this I'm finishing, let me show you now the state machine on the both sides, right? So I have my running in here, I want to stop and to debug this, right? So right now I want to stop, look, I'm stopping the Eclipse, and right now I'm planning to debug, so I'm going in this bug, in the combo box and TCP server, I want to stop into, yes, you know, to stop in the server socket side, right? As long as I'm not executing this command, again, if I'm net stat, I'm not listening anything. If I'm going forward, we step over, right, F6, right? So in this moment, on the macOS here, right, on the macOS, I'm with listening. So I'm in the state machine of listening, right? Me as a server. What is getting out from the listen state to established? If with the blue, the server path, is receiving a SYN packet, and then me as a server automatically I'm replying with this acknowledgement, ACK packet, and I'm getting into establish. On the client side, how is getting from the nothing to connect? Once is sending with the brown path, client receiver path, is sending a SYN packet, SYN send as a state, and then is receiving from the server ACK. So what I have told you, these two packets, clients is sending two packets, server in between is sending SYN ACK, synchronized acknowledgement, in the middle one packet. And let's see this sequence and acknowledgement, these numbers that I have explained a little bit earlier. So right now I'm in listen state. Let me move forward. And right now I'm just clearing the Wireshark. So stop. And I want to not save and to do like this, listening. So as you can see, I'm coming with the right now with the client. I'm getting, if I'm moving forward in here, so the server is listening, F6, while listening, I am in accept blocking accept, but I'm exiting right now because the client already connect to me. And he's saying, look, the client arrived to me, and in between what I can see in here in Wireshark, only three packets actually, besides the push of SYN ACK, right? I also receive, I would like to connect from the client. But I see the handshake, right? Let's spend a few seconds on this handshake. So as you can see, what I have in terms of machine state. So in terms of machine state, because of the handshake, I have established on the macOS side, I have established on the Linux side. So let me show, right? And of course they are in pair, right? So I have this state machine, net start, minus A, NA, now I'm on the Linux side, grape 4801. So you see, I'm connecting from here, 54900 port to 4801, and I have established as a state machine, which is exactly what I have shown you in PowerPoint. Let's move forward. So I have established, and in terms of Wireshark, of network connection, please pay attention, besides the IP header, you see, in here I can expand and say, oh, okay, I want to see what is the source. Look, C0, A801 and B0 is 176. Now is the destination, and I can see this. Now moving forward, besides the IP header, I want and MAC address, MAC address, right? I want to see transmission control protocol, and here I want to see the ports. Look, this is source port D674 in hex, and here is the destination port 12C1 in hex. And besides this, more important, I see the flag. This is only one bit is synchronized. You see SYN, which is value in hex 0002, right? So this is synchronized packet. And then moving forward, most important, I have very important sequence number and acknowledgement number. Is relative sequence number because I have 6B0BF1BB. And what I know from the PowerPoint? I know from the PowerPoint the following. So from the PowerPoint, I know that sequence number is going to be transformed in the acknowledgement from the client plus one. Please pay attention, and with this I'm finalizing. So this in suffix with BB is becoming BC, where when the client, I mean the server 212 is replying back, and as you can see here, I have the TCP header, and in the TCP header, the acknowledgement number is not zero, relative zero anymore, it's plus one. Why? Because BB plus one is becoming BC, but I have the same 6B0BF1BC. So exactly what I have told you in the PowerPoint is respecting in here regarding the state machine on both sides and regarding on the both sides, the communication. And right now, finally, yeah, I have received from the client what? This is the text I have received, the data, 25 bytes. I would like to connect. And because it's coming from Linux, the print line, LN line, is only one enter in Linux mode. I mean, carriage return line feed, no. This is for Windows, but line feed 0A. But here are the text I would like to connect in ASCII format, ISO 8959-1. So I'm receiving this text, right? And this is the packet that I have received. And me on the server side, I'm getting right now the input, I'm obtaining the output, and right now I'm getting the input line, which in this moment is code is null actually, F6 and F6 stop. Look what I have my input line. Of course, I would like to connect. I'm displaying this on the server side, and I'm replying right now on the Wireshark. Me as a server, besides the AC key that you don't see, it is transparent for you as a software developer. The acknowledgement to the push that I received as a packet I would like to connect, I'm going to reply with OK. Look, F6, print line, flash, stop. And now I have this in Wireshark. That's it. So I have replied with this. And as you can see, I have only 3 data bytes. OK, and enter in the macOS type, 0A. And after I did this, I have received yet another request from the client, right? So he's saying, what date is it? And so on and so forth. Because, why so on and so forth? I have here breakpoint in line 51. So I'm going to continue this. Continue. What date is it? Continue. What time is it? You got my point. And now is coming the TCP. Let's start very fast. I'm still in established. I'm waiting 20 seconds. And here I'm in established yet because I'm within the 20 seconds that the client is fooling around with me as a server. I have to wait it, right? And besides this, look, right now I'm obtaining this. Look, in the state machine, I'm here in close wait on the macOS side. On the Linux side, I'm in fin wait 2. And right now I'm going to reply because I have received in the Wireshark the finished packet from the client, this one. I'm going to step over F6 and I have sent my own finish packet, as you can see in here. And in the terms of state machine, I had besides the close wait, let me see if I've, okay. I'm getting the fin wait 2 and time wait. What happens in behind? So as you can see in the state machine, right, on the client side, the brown side, you see in Linux in here, I captured both states, fin wait 2 and time wait 2. What happened actually? My client sent a finished packet in the network. When send my client? When he's saying out.close in the source code of Java, right? So in the source code of Java, my client is saying, besides what time is it or la revedere, is saying out.close. I captured this in the Wireshark. I captured this finish from the Linux, as you see, is finish acknowledgement. And then immediately I reply with finish ACK. So as you can see in here, once I replied with this, my state machine was in close wait on the macOS. On the Linux OS, my state machine, and with this, finally I got it. Sorry for keeping you. I'm getting through fin wait 2 to time wait. You see? So let me show you. So fin wait 2 to time wait, this is the path of the client of the Linux side. On the macOS, I just kept the close wait. I missed the last acknowledgement, but in the end of the day, both of the sockets are closed. And in the end of the day, both of the sockets are not in established or close wait anymore. I have only the listen on the server side, and I have only on the Linux side. If I'm going in there, allow me please to go in there. I have, as you can see in here, only nothing because I have closed. That's it. This being said, thank you very much. Let's go to do the presence in online. Sorry for keeping you so long. And allow me please to stop recording and commuting to Romanian language. Thank you very much.